that's another disappointment to take. So much good play and chances, but just couldn't take them. And that 6 minutes in the second half ultimately proved costly, a bit like Saturday, really.
Yeah, I thought we'd play brilliantly tonight. I think we've dominated the game pretty much every facet. More chances, more of the ball. Limit them to very little, really. Yeah, been undone by a long throw and a mistake, unfortunately. So really frustrated, really hurt, but really proud of the way the players played. It's felt like the last couple of games have been slowly coming back to life and being us in terms of how we want the game to look, and the courage that they are being asked to show, and confidence been building up slowly but surely after a really tough period. Not easy place to come tonight at all. One of the best home forms in the league, and they're fifth in the league now. So I'm really pleased with the performance, and I'm really disappointed with the results. I don't think it's what we deserved.
Just on Andy Fishing, you saw the mistake he made at Luton. He probably disappointed with that second goal. Just where's his confidence at the moment? Because most of the players is spot on exactly.
Yeah.
One mistake again,
isn't it? Yeah, he has no choice but to accept what's happened, to come through this period, really. Losing Stephen was a big blow for us. I thought Fish played really well on Saturday. It's a tough time. He's taken a lot of criticism. Social media, all that stuff is not easy for players. We didn't sign another goalkeeper in January, so there's a lot of pressure on him. So we have to find a way to get him through it, which we will, and he'll be better for this period, I'm sure, in the long term. It's just a disappointment for him and for us tonight. That it's one of those things.
You probably showed how thin your squad is. You've got Cameron Conkrey coming back in today, Liam Smith on the bench. I mean, these are young lads with very little experience. Steve Kaplan here tonight to watch as well. Probably seeing just how thin your squad is.
Yeah, it probably highlights how thin the squad is. Also highlights why we're excited about what we can achieve over a long period of time here with some of the young players we've got. I think 10 of the 18 are under 23 tonight. Six are starting 11 as well. So there's loads to be positive about. They train with us every day. They have a real chance. I had a good couple of hours with Steve this afternoon. And he just reinforced the support for what we're doing long term. Asked a lot of questions about a lot of the players, about the period we've just been through. And he's been really supportive since I've been at Swansea, here at the club. And he's been, he's just a good, honest conversation. He offered a lot of support and a lot of encouragement. And we spoke a lot about the summer, about what the team needs, what the squad needs. As I said to you before, it's a huge summer for the club in terms of there's going to have to be a lot of people coming into the building and a lot of attributes that we haven't been able to sign last summer or in January, which is what we've been crying out for, really, which would really help the team because, I'm really proud of the way the team plays and the identity the team has. And we just haven't quite got the final pieces in the jigsaw, really. We've probably been two or three players away from being a really top team at the level, is our opinion. I think the stats back that up. But we love the group we've got, and there'll be loads of them that move forward with us, and there'll be some that will of us naturally move on. That's football, that's life. So we'll continue to plan for that the whole time we're here. And we need to get a win very quickly to relax a few people and to grow the lads' confidence even further than what it was tonight. But I love the courage they showed today. I love the intensity they showed. We were great tonight. Whatever anyone wants to say, we were really good tonight. So I'm really pleased with that. And I said to them, if you play like that on Sunday at home, would the crowd be right behind you? You play with that courage, that attitude, the mentality. And if we play like that on Sunday, I'm really confident we'll win.
Having spoken with Steve today and recent weeks, we all know what happened in January, but do you feel confident that you will get the backing that you need? Because it's clear that you do need certain areas.
Yeah, I think... again, like Steve is one of a number of directors or co-owners, so he'll obviously speak to Jason and Jake and those guys a lot. But he's really clear on what I feel we need. I think he agrees with a lot of it, and he's really supportive as well. And he's trying really hard to make sure that we have the capability to do what the club needs in the summer. So we'll just have to wait and see on the rest of it. But we're really clear on what we need, we're really clear on who we would like, but we need to finish this season as well as possible to build some momentum ahead of that.
And just a check on Ollie Cooper as well,
his knock was a bit worse than we thought on Saturday, so we took him off at half time. Obviously he was struggling and he just hasn't been able to get over that, so it's just a bit of bone bruising. We hope to have him back for Sunday, we'll have to wait and see, but it'd be good for him and for us to get him in the squad for Sunday ahead of him going away of Wales, which he thoroughly deserves. Really pleased for him, really proud of him. So hopefully he can be available for Sunday.
Like you said, at Bristol City, one more game now. We saw the reaction of the fans in the Middlesbrough game. They were well on board. They backed you from the start. I've been a little bit more nervous in that Rotherham game. Having played like tonight, you're feeling more confident than you maybe would have done going into the previous home game.
Yeah, I'll accept us. Like, the goals we concede are really poor, but I can always accept us looking like that away from home. To be that brave and that dominant, I'll always accept that. So football, sometimes the result doesn't reflect what's happened on the pitch. I think tonight's one of those occasions. But if we play that out on Sunday, I'll be more than happy.